In the news now. The UK government has announced the introduction of COVID Plan B measures in England. The Prime Minister's former press secretary has resigned from government amid number 10 lockdown party revelations. Boris Johnson is under intense scrutiny as he continues to insist no rules were broken with the number 10 lockdown party. The British citizenship of 6 million people could be jeopardised after the government passed a controversial bill. A UK government scheme which will see non-Irish EU citizens living in the Republic required to apply online for pre-travel clearance into Northern Ireland has been branded unworkable by one commentator. The government's flagship immigration legislation cleared the House of Commons after MPs gave the Nationality and Borders Bill a third reading by 298 votes to 231, majority 67, thereby allowing it to progress to the House of Lords. Under the bill, such non-EU citizens will be required to apply for a US-style visa waiver known as an Electronic Travel Authorization, ETA, before entering the UK, including when crossing the land border into Northern Ireland. The UK has joined the US and Australia in the diplomatic boycott of the Beijing Winter Olympics. Two Democratic senators joined Republicans on Wednesday night to adopt a measure that would overturn President Biden's COVID-19 vaccine mandate for private businesses that have 100 or more employees. The GOP-led resolution needed 51 votes in the split Senate to be approved under the Congressional Review Act, which gives Congress the ability to repeal actions by the executive branch. The two Democratic votes came from Senators John Tester of Montana and Joe Manchin of West Virginia, who said last week that he does not support any government vaccine mandate on private businesses. It's highly unlikely that the measure will pass the House, and if so, Biden would almost certainly veto it. Millions of homes were moments away from losing power after a major energy network was hit by a ransomware attack believed to have been the work of Chinese hackers. CS Energy was hit by the attack on Saturday, November 27, in what the chief executive officer has described as a worrying, growing trend. According to the Daily Telegraph, the attack was stopped at the last minute before it had the potential to shut down two major thermal coal plants. If the attack had been successful, 3,500 megawatts of power would have been taken out of the grid, enough for between 1.4 and 3 million homes. We are very much aware that many nations, including China, have significantly increased their cyber capability. Australia is also increasing its legitimate and lawful cyber activity as well. Home Affairs Minister Karen Andrews said cybersecurity was her number one priority. Google has taken action against a major hacking operation that it thinks has infected more than 1 million devices. The tech giant is coming down hard on the so-called Glubtoba botnet, suing two Russians who are allegedly behind it. It's a notorious piece of malware known for taking control of people's Windows PCs. Crooks can then steal people's details and data, as well as using your machine to mine cryptocurrency. At times, the vicious attack was spreading at a rate of thousands of new devices per day. Google said it has disrupted the operation by terminating about 63 million Google Docs detected sharing Glubtoba, more than 1,100 Google accounts and even 870 Google ads. But it warned the criminal masterminds running things have already taken steps to keep the network running. More news later.